Welcome, everybody. Glad you're here with us again.
Hey, if this is the first time you're tuning in to City Kids Online, we're so glad you're here. I'm Cheryl. This is Pastor Joel. Welcome, you guys.
Yeah, you know, last week we were hearing about how Jesus was tempted.
He was, but Jesus used the Bible. He used scripture as his weapon, and he beat the devil.
That's right, he did. But what happened after that?
Well, Jesus started his mission.
Mission. Whoa.
What are you doing?
Mission.
Oh my gosh. Joel. I don't think that's the kind of mission Jesus was on.
Are you sure?
I'm positive. Hey, calm down. We got important stuff to do.
Okay.
Do you remember the big picture question?
Yeah, I think I do. Why did Jesus become a secret agent?
No, silly. That was not it. Why did Jesus become human?
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah. So, what's the answer?
Well, Jesus became human to intercept a secret spy's plan.
No. That's not it. Jesus became human to fulfill his Father's plan and to rescue sinners.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So, I wonder what Jesus' mission looked like.
Well, Jesus and his disciples, they were baptizing people.
You mean like John the Baptist was doing?
Exactly. But, you know, John the Baptist's followers, they were kind of wondering what Jesus and his disciples were doing. They were arguing about it.
That's very interesting. Yeah. Well, let's see what happened. Watch this.
Jesus and his disciples went out into the countryside. People came to see them, and Jesus taught the people. Many people were baptized. Nearby, John the Baptist was baptizing people too. Some of the people who followed John got into an argument. They went to John. "Teacher," they said, "remember the man you talked about, the one who was with you on the other side of the Jordan River? His disciples are baptizing people, and people are starting to follow him." John's followers were talking about Jesus. John answered them, "You heard me say that I am not the Messiah. I am the messenger who goes before him to announce that he is coming." This was true. John had said, "Someone greater than me is coming. I am not worthy to remove his sandals. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." John tried to explain by talking about a wedding. When two people get married, the man who marries the bride is the groom. His friend stands with him at the wedding, and he is happy to be there and hear the groom's voice. John also knew that a wedding is the groom's special day. The groom's friend should not make it about himself. This was how John felt, like a groom's friend, because he was happy that Jesus, the Messiah, had come. John said, "Jesus must increase, but I must decrease." Then John explained why Jesus was more important than himself. John was from the earth, and he could only talk about things on earth. Jesus, the one who comes from heaven, talked about things in heaven because he had seen them. Still, no one believed what Jesus said. Whoever believes Jesus knows that God tells the truth. God sent Jesus to earth, and Jesus speaks God's words. The Father loves the Son and has given him power over everything. Whoever believes in the Son will have eternal life, but whoever refuses to believe in the Son will not have eternal life. He will never be able to get away from God's judgment. John the Baptist told people to get ready for Jesus, the promised Messiah. Now that Jesus was on earth, John's mission was complete. Jesus was greater than John, and John joyfully stepped aside as Jesus began his earthly ministry.
So, John's mission was to point people or get people ready for Jesus' coming.
That's right. His job was to give attention to Jesus because Jesus is the Messiah, and Jesus' mission was just beginning.
You know, now I think I understand what our Bible verse means.
You do?
John was saying that he would have to become less and less, mm-hmm. and Jesus would have to become greater and greater.
That's right. Let's practice our memory verse together. This is what it says. He must become greater and greater, and I must become less and less. John chapter 3, verse 30. So City Kids, stand up on your feet. Let's practice our motions together. He must become greater and greater, and I must become less and less. John chapter 3, verse 30.
You know, John wanted people to get ready for Jesus. He knew that Jesus was coming.
That's right. You know, when Jesus died on the cross and he rose again, shortly after that, he ascended or he went to heaven. But the Bible tells us he's coming back again. And he's coming for all of the people who have accepted him as their Savior, all of us who are followers of Jesus. And we will one day live in heaven with him.
You know, I guess that means that we can have the same kind of mission that John had, where we want people to know about Jesus.
That's right.
But you know, I wonder, what can I say to people? I don't even know if I have the right words.
You know, it's easy. You just need to remember A, B, C. A, which says admit that you are a sinner. B says believe that Jesus died for your sins. And C, confess. Confess that you need Jesus' forgiveness. That's all you need to do to remember.
That's pretty easy. A, B, C. I can remember that.
Yes, you can.
So I know when I see my friends, I can say, hey, all you have to do is admit that you're a sinner, believe that Jesus died on the cross and rose again, and confess your sins. That's easy. I can do that.
Yes, you can. And so can you, City Kids. Next time you get to see your friends or maybe talk to a family member who doesn't know about Jesus, remember A, B, C. Admit, believe, and confess.
You know, I'm glad you guys were with us again today. We would love to hear from you. So you can email us at castile@citypointchurch.com. And maybe you'll see us again next week.
Hey, also check out all of the activities to do on our webpage, citypointchurch.com/citykids. Can't wait to see you next time.
Love ya.